Because I'm getting a lot of questions lately about hand position with kettlebells and just kind of sparing the hand and taking care of calluses and kind of avoiding, you know, calluses, ripping, blisters, things like that, particularly with high frequency work, which we see a lot in kettlebells. So the biggest thing with kettlebells is the bell's always going to be in two positions. It's either going to be in your fingers or it's going to be down across this 45 degree angle on your hand, but never in between. A common mistake with the bells is to kind of over grab the bell with the palm, pinching the calluses and just causing a lot of irritation there. What you want to do for a lot of your holds, your swings, your carries, things like that, is we're going to start with a finger grip and we're going to close the palm around the grip versus starting with more of a palmed grip, kind of like an overcompensation, and then closing the fingers around that, which pinches the calluses and leads to callus buildup, eventually tear, irritation, things like that. So we're always going to start with that finger position and then wrap the hand around it. As we get into some of the rack positions and our presses, you want to look more at this 45 degree angle. Wrist is always straight, always neutral, and then that bell is coming down at this 45 degree angle, and we'll close the hand around that. And as we transition from things like snatches, what we're going to find is the bell is going to finish in this 45 degree angle, but as we kind of flip it down, it's going to drop into the fingers again and kind of in this hooked grip when we're using bells. So give it a shot, play around with it, and see if your hands feel a little better.